Hello there, Marty Ward here, your transformation strategist. The tip of the week this week: the only way out is through. You know, we keep wanting life to, we just want life to work out. We keep wanting it not to have to be that we have to look inside, do the work, and really own it, really own what needs to shift in our lives, to transform. And you know, as I said, you know, if there was a helicopter to get from where we are to where we want to be, I would have found it, and I would have been able to buy like three with all the money I spent avoiding doing the work, trying to find an answer outside of me, to blame somebody else, to find, I don't know, anything but me. And it's really you allowing yourself to decode your feelings deep down and know what it is that you're running from. You know, sometimes it seems so despicable that we can't look. But that very seemingly despicable feeling that we're judging as despicable is our best friend, just waiting there to give you the information that you need. You know, often when I decode feelings with my clients, meaning that when you decode a feeling, you go from angry. When you feel angry, how do you feel? I feel frustrated. When I feel frustrated, how do I feel? I feel resentful. When I feel resentful, how do I feel? I feel remorse. When I feel remorse, how do I feel? I feel guilty. When I feel guilty, how do I feel? I feel torn. And when we get down, often we'll get down, I feel dead. And then they think that there's nothing under that dead. Makes sense, doesn't it? But you see, you know those movies with the zombies? Right? Walking around? Well, Hollywood wanted to awaken us, to awaken us to how we have deadened ourselves, to how we are walking around without owning all of who we are, and shutting ourselves down, denying ourselves pleasure, stopping ourselves from being alive and vital and aware and exhilarated and fun and playful and joyous and sensual, sexual, and all those fabulous things. But Hollywood's trying to show us that. Because you see, under dead has the best information. Because it's where you killed yourself off. Where have you killed yourself off? With a client I worked with the other day, it was when he was in college. And he had an A in photography, but he wasn't doing so well in some other subjects. And he wanted to take a particular course to move forward with his photography, and the dean said, nah, we're not gonna let you. We're not gonna let you do that because you didn't do this other work here. And poof, he shut down that creative, artistic, imaginative, inventive, fabulous, alive, vital, aware aspect of himself. And then he was going to go into real estate. And then he was told that wasn't it. How many of us have done that to ourselves? What is it that you have deadened inside of you? What is it that you are not allowing to be expressed? And denying yourself the pleasure, the joy, the satisfaction. What is it? Because that's where the money lies. That's where the pleasure lies. That's where the joy and excitement lies. Because when you decode those feelings and then you look at the opposite of each of your feelings, What is the opposite of dead? Alive. Exactly. So it's where you need to aliven yourself that the work is, which is merely, although it's hard, it is merely doing what you love. We're not that complicated, we human beings. The universe didn't make us that complicated. Dualistic, up, down, right, wrong, left, right, dead, alive. Regret, joy, remorse, excited, depressed, which is pushing down your power. So whatever that power is, not speaking up for yourself, honoring and valuing who you are, the opposite of depressed is speaking up for yourself, honoring and valuing who you are. That's it. But it's doing the work. It's allowing yourself to know where you have deadened yourself so that you can be alive. Have a fabulous week discovering more of who you are and alivening yourself and enjoying life. Well, enjoying you, more importantly.